अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीवन, आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर फाइन। सो लेट्स बिगिन विद अवर डिस्कशन ऑन टुडेज टॉपिक, दैट इज रियलिज्म एंड नेचुरलिज्म। सो रियलिज्म एंड नेचुरलिज्म स्टार्टेड इन 1850s एंड एंडेड इन 1900s। दीज वर टू मूवमेंट्स दैट स्टार्टेड आफ्टर रोमांटिसिज्म। दीज वर बेसिकली अ रिएक्शन टू रोमांटिसिज्म। बोथ मूवमेंट्स अटेम्प्ट टू पेंट रियलिस्टिक इमेज थ्रू लिटरेचर। So, what is realism? The quality or facts of representing a person, things or situation accurately or in a way that is true to life is called realism. It stands for authenticity or truthfulness. So, there is some literally or literary realism as well. It was a part of realistic art movement. In literature, it is described as theory in which natural world or life is represented accurately without the practice of idealizing occurrences of life. Works of George Eliot and William Dean Howells are for some of the earliest example of this writing. There are some of the background of realism as well. Realism art movement started in France in 1850s after the revolution of 1848. Realists reject romanticism, which dominated the French literature and art since late 18th century. Realism revolted against exaggerated emotionalism and drama of romantic movement. Now, what is naturalism? Naturalism is a philosophical viewpoint according to which everything arises from natural properties and causes and supernatural explanation are excluded in this point of views. So, the naturalistic writers write stories based on ideas that environment determines and governs human characters. Some scientific principles are present in naturalism as well. It uses idea from Darwin's theory of evolution, which holds that life is a struggle and only the fittest can survive. There is also a background of naturalism as well. Naturalism started as a movement in 19th century in literature, film, theater and art. This movement suggested roles of family, social condition and environment in human characters. Works of Emile Zola, Stephen Crane and Jack London are the example of naturalistic writings. So there is some differences and similarities between realism versus naturalism as well. Realism focuses on presenting the characters in more real way, whereas naturalism explains why they are the way they are. While the second important characteristics or the difference is the naturalism focuses on the natural forces predetermine a character's decisions, making him or her act in particular way, while realism says that the decision of a character comes from his response to certain situation. Realism focuses on literary techniques, while naturalism suggests a philosophical pessimism in which writers uses scientific technique to depict human beings as weak entity influenced by natural forces. In realism, the main focus was on middle class and its problem, and in naturalism, the main focus was on poorly educated or lower class characters and on themes involving violence and taboo activities. Now, some of the naturalistic writers include Emile Zola. He was a French author. He basically talks about humans, that humans are analyzed like any other beast. He wrote Human Beast in 1890s, while the second one is Stephen Crane. Stephen Crane was an American playwright and novelist, and he wrote an important work, The Open Boat. It conveys the feeling of loveliness that comes from a man's understanding that he is alone in the universe. While there are some of the realistic writers as well, the first one is George Eliot. She basically wrote an important novel like Mill on the Floss, Mary Ann Evans, Mundane Details of Provincial Life. In Mill on the Floss, it is an important novel by her. It is about love goes hand in hand with suffering, which is pretty much par for the course. Everything goes hand in hand with suffering here. The second one is William Dean Howells. He was also an important realistic writer. He wrote The Rise of Silas Lapham, in which he talks about the story of family to adjust in higher class society. So there is a realism and naturalism genre of poetry as well. So War is Kind is the poem by Stephen Crane is the best example of both realistic and naturalistic poetry. It is a piece that is extremely critical on war and question if war and the death and destructions that results it truly worth it through or the use of structure and sarcasm. Crane attempts to sway the mind of the reader to be critical, towards war and to see it for what it really is. The poem portrays the pain of separation caused by the brutality of war. Therefore, Crane's criticism is directed towards warmongers and not strictly towards the overpowering forces of nature. And that's all from my side. Please like, subscribe, and share my channel. Thank you so much for watching.